गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी विल रीड लेसन 7 ऑफ क्लास 6, भारत देश पोएम। दिस पोएम हैज़ बीन रिटन बाय सुब्रमण्या भारती। दिस इज अबाउट आवर कंट्री भारत देश। लेट्स रीड द पोएम। दिस इज अ वेरी ब्यूटिफुल पोएम विद द नेम ऑफ भारत देश ऑन आवर लिप्स। लेट अस shake off our fears and poverty and overcome our sorrows and enemies. We shall stroll on the snow-clad silvery heights of the Himalayas. Our ships shall sail across the high seas. We shall set up schools, all sacred temples for us, and proudly thump our shoulders and utter the name of this land of ours, Bharat. With the name of Bharat Desh on our lips, let us shake off our fears and poverty. We shall make tools and weapons. We shall produce paper. We shall open factories and schools. We shall never be lazy or weary. We shall be ever generous. We shall always speak the truth. With the name of Bharat Desh on our lips, let us shake off our fears and poverty. Both scriptures and sciences we shall learn. The heavens and oceans we will explore. The mysteries of moon we shall unravel. The art of street sweeping too we shall learn. With the name of Bharat Desh on our lips, let us shake off our fears and poverty. This is the poem, children. You can see how beautifully the poet is presenting here the poem Bharat Desh. He wanted to say that let's do it. Let's shake off all the fears. Let's remove all the fears and poverty. With taking the name of Bharat Desh, let's overcome all our sorrows and enemies. चलो हम लोग सारी fears, poverty हटा दें, सारे sorrows और enemies पे काबू पा लें. We shall stroll on the snow-clad, silvery heights of the Himalayas. और फिर हम लोग हिमालयाज के silvery heights पे, silvery means snow, it is all covered by snow, that's why he called it silvery heights. तो हम लोग हिमालयाज के बर्फ वाले जो चोटी है उस पे चढ़ें, उस पे जाएं. Our ships shall sail across the high seas. और ऊंची ऊंची लहरों के बीच में हमारा ships जो है वो चलेगा. We shall set up schools, all sacred temple for us. और हम लोग स्कूल सेट अप करेंगे जो हमारे लिए एक पवित्र मंदिर है. You can see here, children, that it is an indirect comparison between school and temple. Means not directly he is comparing between school and temple. Indirectly he is doing comparison. And this indirect comparison, which is implied, means which is understood, we can understand that he is comparing school with temple. It means it is metaphor. The figure of speech metaphor is in this line. And proudly thump our shoulders and utter the name of this land of ours, Bharat. And then we pat our shoulders and then we call the name of Bharat, our country, our land. And with the name of Bharat Desh on our lips, let us shake off all our fears and poverty. Let's remove all fears and poverty. Why? We shall make tools and weapons now. Now, in future, we shall make tools and weapons. We shall produce paper for our country. We shall open factories and schools for our country. We shall never be lazy or weary. Weary means tired. We shall never be lazy or weary. Means we will be active always. We shall be ever generous to others. वी शैल बी काइंड टू अदर्स, वी शैल स्पीक ट्रूथ ऑलवेज, वी शैल नेवर टेल अ लाई, एंड देन विद द नेम ऑफ भारत देश ऑन आवर लिप्स, लेट्स कॉल द नेम भारत देश ऑफ आवर कंट्री विद रिमूविंग ऑल द फियर्स एंड पॉवर्टी, बिकॉज वी शैल लर्न बोथ थिंग, स्क्रिप्चर्स एंड साइंसेस बोथ. स्क्रिप्चर्स मीन्स आवर कल्चर एंड सिविलाइजेशन, एंड साइंसेस बोथ वी शैल लर्न, एंड वी शैल एक्सप्लोर एवरीथिंग, ओशंस ऑल्सो एंड द हेवेंस ऑल्सो. हेवेंस मीन्स वट एवर इन आवर स्पेस. द मिस्ट्रीज ऑफ मून वी शैल अनरेवल, वी शैल अनफोल्ड द मिस्ट्रीज ऑफ मून ऑल्सो, एंड देन नॉट ओनली वी विल डू बिग थिंग, वी विल डू स्मॉल थिंग ऑल्सो. वी शैल लर्न द आर्ट ऑफ स्ट्रीट स्वीपिंग ऑल्सो. विद द नेम ऑफ भारत देश ऑन आर लिप्स, लेट अस शेक ऑफ आर फियर्स एंड पॉवर्टी. सो लेट्स कॉल द नेम ऑफ भारत देश बाय रिमूविंग all the fears and poverty from our country, and we will do all these things which is given in your poem. Hope you like this poem, children. Now let's do some exercises. This is just like a summary, children. Now read the gist of the poem given below. Fill in the blanks with appropriate words or phrases. Let's do it. Through the poem Bharat Desh, the speaker wants us to shake off our fears and poverty. The spelling given here is wrong. You will correct it. P-O-V-E-R-T-Y, poverty, and set up school for the students. Schools will be correct. He wants us to produce tools, weapons, and paper. He advises us not to be lazy or weary and try to be generous. He wants his countrymen to know more about heavens. Again, the spelling of heaven is wrong. Here you can write it H-E-A-V-E-N-S, heavens, oceans, and moon. Following all this, our country shall rise high and prosper. Now, second. Now let's do match the following. On the basis of your understanding of the poem, match the following phrases appropriately as done in the example. Shake off fears and poverty. Stroll on snow-clad silvery heights. You can take the help of poem also. And if you have learned the poem, you can do it yourself. Sail across the high seas. Set up schools, all sacred temples. Thump our shoulders. Make factories and schools. Produce make tools and weapons. Produce paper. Open factories and schools. Then never be lazy or weary. Ever be generous. Speak truth, the truth. Learn scriptures and sciences both. Explore heavens and oceans. Unravel the mysteries of moon. Okay, children, this is the matching words. Match the following. All these are given in your poem. You can take the help from that poem also. or otherwise you can see the number written here and do it. Now read the following extracts. We shall set up schools, all sacred temples. We shall set up schools, all as sacred as temples. You can see that same sentence is written in two ways. In first one, means in number A, all we shall set up schools, all sacred temples. You can see that here comparison is indirect. Means directly it is not comparing school with temple. But it is understood that in this sentence school is being compared with temple. So in this type of sentence, this type of figure of speech, what is the name of this figure of speech, children? Metaphor. Where the comparison is indirect but implied, means but understood, is called metaphor. And let's see second one. We shall set up schools all as sacred as temples. You can see here, this is direct comparison. You can see as sacred as temples. Here it is saying that school is the place which is as sacred as temple. Means school is being compared with temple here with the word as. If we will compare a word by using as, like, so, it means it is simile. Simile is also a figure of speech and metaphor is a figure of speech also. But the difference between these two are direct comparison, indirect comparison. One is implied and one is direct by using as, like, or so. Here definition is given. You can learn here. The comparison between schools and temple is not direct but implied in A number. This implied comparison is called a metaphor. And in extract B, the schools are being compared to temples directly. This direct comparison between two things is called a simile. Directly with the word as, you can see here, as sacred as quick as mouse, as long as road. This is simile. Red like a rose. If we are using like, then also it is simile. Now let's do the fill in the blanks. What is here? Four words are given: monkey, lion, cheetah, rabbit. You have to fill. The baby has a soft skin. Her rabbit skin fascinated me. This is a comparison, but again indirect comparison. Rabbit skin. It means skin is being compared with rabbit, like soft like rabbit. So it is metaphor here. Ravi is the bravest soldier in the army. He is a lion amongst others. Lion. He is not a lion, but he is like a lion. But we are comparison he with lion indirectly. So it is metaphor again. If we will say he is like a lion, it means it is simile. Shiv is a very swift child. He is the cheetah of his class. Again metaphor. He is like the cheetah, simile. But he is the cheetah, metaphor. Because he is not the cheetah, but we are comparing him with cheetah, which is implied, not direct. Chintu imitates his elder brother. His brother gets irritated by his little monkey. Monkey means Chintu is naughty like a monkey, not a monkey. So it is again metaphor. If the sentence is that Chintu is naughty like a monkey, or his brother gets irritated by his little brother who is like a monkey, it means it is metaphor, it is simile. But here the comparison is indirect, means indirectly we are just understood that Chintu is like a monkey. That's why it is metaphor, not a simile. Okay, in four of the sentences द फिगर ऑफ स्पीच इज मेटाफर. ओके चिल्ड्रन, होप यू लाइक दिस वीडियो. थॉट्स, लाइफ स्किल्स, वैल्यूज एंड राइटिंग स्किल्स वी विल डू इन माई नेक्स्ट वीडियो. टिल देन सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल, लाइक इट, शेयर इट विथ योर फ्रेंड्स एंड डोंट फॉरगेट टू प्रेस द बेल आइकन. कमेंट ऑन